What's up guys, Master here, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make a profile picture on Photoshop for your YouTube channel. So first you want to go new, and you want to make sure that it is, that's the thumbnail size. If you want to make thumbnails, it is 500 by 500. Then it should look just like this, like that. It's a perfect size for profile pictures. Then you want to get what kind of background you want. Where's a good one? Choose this. Shit. Make sure it doesn't have the little watermarks across it. So we'll try and don't use one like that, because that's basically using a template if you do that. Does this one have any things? Okay, we'll do this one. Save image as. I usually open it so it makes it like more HD, but oh yeah, we'll just do JPG. Blah. And then you want to make sure, I already have one, but you just go, you don't have to have this, but it makes it look a lot better. So you just get like one of these. Make sure it's transparent background, or you can just wipe it out. Anyway, I use a thinner one. I'll show you exactly what one I have. That one, it's thinner. Looks better. Okay, and you're gonna go place ember, whatever. Sorry. Then we're gonna find it. What I've named it, blah. See, I've made a few pictures. Dickhead. You dickhead. Now, because see, we don't want it like that. We want to stretch it out a bit. That. And then that's perfect now. Alright, so that looks pretty cool. You can kind of pick anyone you want. I'm just going to drag across to the middle. And then, obviously, place again. Find your circle. Obviously, mine. Make it a bit bigger. And then I'm going to use the magic eraser tool. Click OK. Oh no, what am I doing? Magic eraser tool. Okay. Like that. Move this circle to the perfect position, just like that. And then I'm gonna go blending options just here, and then show all effects. Now I'm gonna add a stroke. Obviously, look at that, not that big. I don't know why it's added them things just there, don't worry about that. Just make it, oh, why are they on the side? I really don't know why that's on the side. You probably won't have to put up with this, so you don't worry. Just ignore the things on the side. And then definitely drop a shadow. Where is it? Turn that up. Actually, I like that about there. Change the distance, spread it a bit more. Then make the size just a tiny bit bigger. Yeah, that's about perfect. And then you want to get your text. 100 should be. Download your own fonts off the font. I'll actually put in the description. Just. Yeah. So I'll put that in the description where to get good fonts off. The one I use all the time is this one. So. Caps locks. I'm just gonna go master that. I'd usually make it smaller than the circle, but it doesn't matter right now because I'm just quickly showing you guys. Add a white stroke, or if you have white writing, add a black stroke. But I'm going to add a white stroke. Boom, boom. See how that looks? Make it about there. Nope. Oh, okay. Drop a shadow. And what is going to add a boy look like on here? Okay, and now is where you kind of want to add your own like little character. So take your time though. I'm obviously just demonstrating. Then go down to like 30. Or not 30 actually. Or 48. And then I'll go. The mouse. I did not mean that. And then I'm going to quickly go blending options, stroke shadow. Yeah, just like that. The file place. Place our little SpongeBob that we got. He's massive. Where would he sit? Maybe on top of the circle. I think just about there. He looks pretty good sitting there. And then, if whatever you want, you can kind of find the options for this. Change the colour of it. Obviously, you get a proper one off the internet. Yeah, it's pretty cool. And yeah. So, thanks for watching, guys. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Comment if this tutorial helped you. And comment if you want more tutorials on, you know, art or anything else. So, peace. That first time, she was in my math class. Long hair, brown skin with the...